My first class was actually Bio 270, which is animal physiology. And I didn't realize how big Conn Hall was. And it was my very, very first lecture, the very first time I was lecturing in front of students, and the very first time I had to do it, I literally was shaking. Like, my knees were shaking, my hands were shaking. And so I stood in front of the lectern for probably the good first 15 minutes of lecture, trying not to shake, trying to give a good lecture, and also trying not to have my voice crack or have a really bad nervous breakdown. And that was really traumatic for me, to be honest. I still get very nervous, even after all these years of giving a lecture. You get very, very nervous about having to speak in front of a large group, and I just manage it better. So my name is Dr. Bill Ju. I'm an associate professor in the teaching stream, and I've been here at the human biology program for the last 7 years. I guess my interests would be things like neuroscience, health and disease, anything related to pedagogy or how students learn. When I was in graduate school, my main focus was research. But the one thing that struck me while I was doing my postdoctoral research was that you have to really love your research. The realization after 12 years of investing my time was that I shouldn't stay in research. One of the things that I really enjoyed as part of my research was that I liked teaching. So when students would come in to do their research projects, I would be the person that would teach them the different techniques. That was the one thing that I really enjoyed from research, and that was one of the reasons why I decided to get into teaching. It was a typical route. So I started off as a sessional lecturer, which means that I'm doing one or two courses. And I really enjoyed that experience, so I was looking to do more full-time teaching.
Neuroscience research in neurodegeneration, in Parkinson's, Alzheimer's, etc. Mainly because
I think a professor is someone who is trying to ignite the same passion that they have for a topic in their students. So my favorite prof, and I actually devote a lecture to him, I actually put his picture up there and I actually say, this lecture is devoted to Dr. Mike Wiley. He's just a really nice guy, and I think that comes across in his lectures. He's obviously really bright. He's obviously able to communicate really well. He wants students to understand the material, so he takes his time doing all of those things. Feeling connected, whether it's through your courses with your prof or through other students in the course, is really, really important. In order for you to learn well, you have to feel comfortable in your learning environment, and I think students often take that for granted, that you should be enjoying your studies and not being socially isolated while you are studying. I had a very bad experience in undergrad. I wasn't a very good student, and in many ways I feel that helps me a little bit. As a prof, the main thing that I would do most of the time would be really to advocate for students. I remember and still think about when students are having issues with learning different material, how I struggled with it as well. Students have this sense where they are coming to university, they feel disengaged, they feel like they have no one helping them navigate. And we ask students to be mature, responsible individuals, but sometimes you really do need a little bit of help. You need that a little push, and I think that that would be one thing that I think is the most important thing that I do. The ability that students have to make an impact, not just in arts and science, but outside of the university, and volunteering in the hospital, and finding enjoyment through that, and also impacting the city, is really undervalued. And I think that in many ways students should be doing that. Actually getting to meet students in the last few years and hearing about all the things that they want to try is really amazing. So I really enjoy that part of it the most. Students, based on what I post and when they actually meet me, they say, "But you're so different than how your Facebook profile or your posts are." I think I have one more hair, that I'm cooler than I am. I just think they have a very different sort of feeling of what my personality would be, and I think that's a detriment in some cases. And in some cases, it's actually a lot of fun when I can actually recognize one of my students because of their profile picture on Facebook. I actually use Facebook in exactly the same ways that you do. So I take pictures with my class, and it's not to promote my class, it's really to remember my students. When students come back and they tell me like what great things have happened to them, or the types of things that they've gone on to do outside of the classroom and after they've graduated, or even while they're still here, that makes up for all the many hours of struggles that we have in the classroom.